Electronic Devices and Circuits. My name is Professor Omkar Vaidya with Professor Manjul Nikam. I welcome you to the sessions of Electronic Devices and Circuits Practicals. Our first practical is design a single stage FET CS configuration and verify DC operating point. So first of all, what do you mean by DC operating point? So if we draw the characteristic, output characteristic of FET, then we can able to draw the DC load line like this. For example, this is the output of ID versus VDS, and when we draw DC load line, at the center we have Q point, that is called as DC operating point, and it has coordinate VDS Q and ID Q. So Q is nothing but VDS Q comma ID Q. So this is called as DC operating point. Okay. Now we have to verify DC operating point and we have to design. So what is basically biasing? Biasing means we apply external DC or AC voltages to the terminal of device, that is called as biasing. So there are different types of biasing in FET. So number one type of biasing is fixed biasing. Second type of biasing is self-biasing. And third type of biasing is voltage divider biasing. So as per the syllabus, we are interested in self-biasing. So we will first of all draw the circuit diagram of self-biasing and then we will try to design what do you mean by self-biasing design. So this is the circuit diagram. This is VDD. This is RD, this is the FET, which is N-channel enhancement type. We have RS and we have RG. This is self-biasing. So we will discuss first of all, what is the significance of each component in the self-biasing type of circuit. So here RD is used to control ID, drain current. Then RS is basically gives a negative feedback to the circuit. Then RG is going to use for biasing resistor. So this is called as self-bias. We do not require external biasing voltage. So and hence it is called as self-bias. Now what is the meaning of design? Design means we are giving parameter. We are giving external parameters like VGS, VDS, pinch off voltage and IDSS. And then we are going to find out the values of these resistances. This is called design time. So in our case, the given values are number one IDSS, which is drain to source saturation current and which is basically 10 milliampere. Then we have VGS minus 2.5 volt. We have V pinch off, which is minus 5 volt, and we have VDS, which is 4 volt. These are the given values. And to design means we have to find out to find these three values of resistances, that is RD, RG and RS. So we have RD, we want to find out RD, RG and RS. Similarly, we also know the value of VDD, which is 12 volt. Now we will try to find out these values, RD, RS and RG. Now first of all, in this case, this is a loop, which is say a complete loop, so we can apply KVL. Through this say IG current flows, through this say ID current flows. Okay, so here we will apply KVL first. So what is the equation for KVL? So current flows from positive to negative, this is completely VGS. So if you want to apply KVL here, the equation is minus IGRG minus VGS minus IDRS is equal to 0. But as we know, the FET has input current which is 0 because FET has high input impedance. So we know that IG is equal to 0. So in this case, this product will be 0. 0 minus VGS minus ID RS is equal to 0. So we can say that VGS is equal to minus ID into RS. We now know the value of VGS, but we don't know the value of ID and RS. But we can able to find out the value of ID because we know the formula of ID. ID is equal to IDSS into 1 minus VGS upon V pinch of bracket square. Now we know the value of IDSS, which is 10 milliampere. We know the value of VGS, which is minus 2.5. We know the value of VP, which is minus 5. So we'll put this value in this formula and we'll try to find out the value of ID. So we'll try to find out this, which is 10 into 10 raised to minus 3 into 1 minus VGS is minus 2.5. So minus 2.5 divided by VP is minus 5. This complete bracket square. So how this equation will work? 2.5 divided by 5, which is basically 0.5. This minus minus will term will get cancelled. So this will become 1 minus 0.5. So 1 minus 0.5 is 0.5. So we can have 10 into 10 raised to minus 3 into 0.5 bracket square. So 0.5 bracket square is 0.25 into 10 into 10 raised to minus 3. So this will be 2.5 milliampere. So your ID value will be 2.5 milliampere. This is the first thing. So now we'll put this value ID here to find out RS because we know the value of VGS. So similarly from this formula we can able to write down RS is equal to VGS divided by ID. But this minus value we kept here, so I will write minus VGS divided by ID. We already know the value of VGS, which is minus 2.5. So this minus 2.5 and this minus will become plus. So we can say that this is 2.5 divided by this is 2.5 milliampere. ID is 2.5 milliampere. So 2.5 into 10 raised to minus 3. This will cancel. So this minus 10 in denominator we have 10 raised to minus 3. We'll be going 10 raised to plus 3 in numerator. And here we'll have 1000. So this 1000 is the value of RS. So we can say truly this RS value is 1 kilo. So this is the first case we have found out the value of RS. Now second thing, then we'll find out the value of RD and RG similarly. Now we'll apply KVL to this output loop. So how this equation becomes if we apply KVL to output loop? So current flows through RD, which is say ID, and current flows from positive to negative. And similarly, through RS also current flows from positive to negative. And across this, we have VDS. This is drain terminal, this is source terminal, and this is gate terminal. So across this, we have VDS. So if we apply KVL, that is from through this branch, VDD, then RD, then across this FET, then RS, and towards ground, the equation becomes VDD minus ID RD minus VDS minus ID RS is equal to 0. So from this equation we came to know the value of ID. VDS is given, VDD is also known, RS value we have just found out, which is 1 kilo ohm. So only unknown value is RD, and that is our next parameter to find. So we can able to find out RD very simple. We can construct this equation in such a way that we can able to find out this value of RD. So we can write down VDD minus VDS minus ID RS is equal to ID into RD. Now we'll keep this, the term which is on RHS, we'll keep into denominator of term in LHS. So we can write down this in such a way that this ID will become here. So your value of RD, the formula becomes VDD minus VDS minus ID RS upon ID. We know the value of ID, which is 2.5 milliampere. VDD is at 12 volt, VDS is 4 volt, and RS value is we have 1 kilo ohm. Now from this we put all this value here, like 12 minus 4 minus. So this ID, we have 2.5 into 10 to the minus 3, which is 2.5 milliampere. We have Rs, which is equal to 1 into 10 to the 3, which is 1 kilo ohm, divided by this value again, 2.5 into 10 to the minus 3, is equal to the Rd. So if we solve this equation, we will get the value of Rd. Rd becomes 2.2 kilo ohm. So the value of Rd is here is 2.2 kilo ohm. So up till we have found out the value of Rs, which is 1 kilo ohm, and Rd, which is 2.2 kilo ohm. Now next is Rg. Rg is basically self-bias resistor. So this value must be very high because input impedance of FET is very high, and this Rg acts as input impedance in our circuit. So the value of Rg, we will assume here, the highest value, or which is the highest possible value of Rg we can have. So we will assume the value of Rg as 1 mega ohm. So such a way, first of all we have designed the circuit based on this given parameter. So we have found out the value of Rd, which is 2.2 kilo ohm. We have found out the value of Rg that we have assumed, which is 1 mega ohm, and we have found out the value of Rs, which is 1 kilo ohm. Now based on this value of resistances and this particular parameter we know, now we'll build the circuit on breadboard. So after building this circuit on breadboard, how this circuit completely will be look like, that we'll see here. So again I will redraw the circuit diagram. So the value of Rg, which is 1 mega ohm, the value of Rs, which is 1 kilo ohm, this is FET. So practically we will use BMW10, which is n-channel JFET. Then we have Rd value, which is 2.2 kilo ohm, and we have VDD, which is 12 ohm. So we will construct this value, or we will construct this circuit on a breadboard, and we will find out practically the values of number 1 VGS, then we will find out the value of VDS, and similarly we will find out the value of drain current that flows through this RD with the help of digital multimeter. So with the help of digital multimeter we will find out VGS, that is practically, then VDS, and third one is ID. So this practical value we have to verify with the theoretical value that we have already, either we have given or either we have derived with the help of formula. So what are the theoretical values that we have already known? The value of VGS we have already known was minus 2.5 volt, the value of VDS was 4 volt, and the ID value we have found out with the formula, which is 2.5 milliampere. So this is theoretical value. What do you mean by verify DC operating point? The verification of DC operating point means we will find out by constructing this circuit on breadboard, and with the BMM we will find out VGS, VDS and ID, and this value must be nearby this minus 2.5 volt for VGS, 4 volt for VDS and 2.5 milliampere for ID. So whether the values are comparable, then we can say that we have verified DC operating point, and this is our experiment number 1. Thank you. We have drawn this circuit, which is VDD 12 volt, RD 2.2 kilo ohm, and here we will use BFW10, which is N channel JFET. Then we have RS 1 kilo ohm, and this is RG 1 mega ohm. So this is self bias configuration for CS JFET circuit. Now we have BFW10, which is N channel JFET and which has 4 terminals. So as per this bottom view of BFW10 circuit, there are 4 terminals, and how to identify this 4 terminal. So this is when you go clockwise from the notch, this is basically called as notch,
And from notch, if you go clockwise, we have source, drain, gate and substrate. For example, in this case, this is a notch. Notch means certain swelling across this circular, which is just basically a notch. So this terminal is source, this terminal is drain, this is gate and this is substrate. Basically, JFET has only three terminals. So substrate and source, these two terminals must be short-circuited with each other, so that we have only source, drain and gate. Now we want to construct this circuit on breadboard. So how to construct this circuit? This notch should be towards our side, and so that we have to mount this circuit in between these two compartments. For example, here. So we have mount this N-channel JFET, which is BFW10. So notch is towards my side and this will become source, this is drain, this is gate and this is substrate. So this is source and substrate. We already know source and substrate should be short circuited. So now this holes is for source and this holes is for substrate. So we can use any hole and we can connect it. So I have used this source and this substrate, so that I have done short circuited. Source and substrate must be short circuited. Now as per the diagram, circuit diagram, this is drain, this is source terminal and this is gate terminal. So source terminal, we have one resistor which is of 1 kilo ohm. So this is 1 kilo ohm resistor. So from color coding we can understand which is brown, black, red. So as we know the BBRY, that formula, so it becomes 1 kilo ohm. So brown, black, red is basically 1 kilo ohm. So I will construct in between source terminal and ground. So I will treat this as ground line, this particular power line as ground. So this is source, RS is to be connected in between this. So I have connected RS. Similarly, there is one more resistance which is RG, which is in between gate and ground. So this is gate terminal, which is of 1 mega ohm. So this is basically 1 mega ohm, means we have brown, then we have black and then we have green color. So this is 1 mega ohm. So 1 mega ohm is to be connected in between this. So what we have done, one terminal is connected to gate terminal. So there are different holes horizontally. We can choose any one. We have chosen this and this is common for ground. So ground here we have to take care about horizontal, and here I have to take care about vertical. Similarly, there is one more resistor called RD, which is 2.2 kilo ohm. So it is very easily identified because all colors on color coding on this is red. So this is red, 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 which is 2.2 kilo ohm. So consider that this is your RD that I have connected. So this is your drain side. So these are the drain terminals. So we can choose any one of the hole from this drain side. So I have connected RD and here consider that I have chosen VDD line. So VDD line is this much to this much and this is RD. So I have constructed the circuit as per circuit diagram and now I will use power supply. So this is what power supply is. So this is basically power supply, which is 0 to 30 volt 2 ampere dual channel. So I will use this channel. So there are different channels. This is channel number 1, this is channel number 2. So this red means this is positive and this black means this is negative. And this middle is ground, generally when used when we want dual, especially in op amp. For example, in that case we common this 2 because there is one more channel here. This is positive, this is negative and we have to take ground common and then we use plus VCC and minus V in case of op amp. There is one more supply, that is this 0 to 5 volt 2 ampere. It will use only 5 volt supply. So but here we will use this supply because I want 12 volt VDD as per the circuit. So there are these buttons. Basically this is for voltage button and this is for current button for this channel or this particular supply. And again there is voltage and current button for this supply. So I want to vary now voltage. with the help of this coarse and fine button. Coarse button is to vary the voltage very fast, and fine button is to vary from point, like 12.1, 12.2, like that. So we'll on this. Already it is set at a 12.5, and 12.3, I want to reduce it somehow. With the help of fine, I can reduce it. And now I have taken 11.6, 11.8, like that. So we can cross check with the help of multimeter. Your multimeter now should be, pointer should be on DC voltage. And this red wire is considered as positive, this black is negative. And we'll see which voltage is this. So we plug this red in this red and black in this black. So we'll have 12.19, so 12.2. So this much is the 12 volt VDD. Okay, means this is fine. Now, already we stated that this is my ground and this is my VDD line. So I can have this VDD line anywhere up to this. Means I can construct from this one to this one only in this second row. So let us say I have connected here. Similarly, we have ground line, or we call it as negative voltage, that is ground. We can have from this to this in the first row. So say here I have connected. Now I have built a circuit, I have given the supply. Now next thing is I want to measure voltages across this, voltages across drain and source, that is VDS, voltages across gate and source, that is VGS, and the current flow through this drain current, that is ID. Now with the help of this multimeter I will use. So there are four sockets. So generally if you want to measure voltage or capacitance or resistance or frequency, connect this red always here. This common is always to be connected here. If you want to measure current, then you have to connect current here. If the current is in milliampere range, then connect this socket, or if it is more than up to ampere range, 10 ampere, connect this. So I want voltage, so I will connect here. And now the rotary switch should be at DC voltage, because we are measuring DC voltage. So right, it is at DC voltages. So now I will check DC voltage, that is VDS. So VDS means this red connection is to be connected to drain terminal. So I know this is my drain terminal, this is my source terminal. Okay, so negative, or this red, this is black wire, or this black DMM connector is to be connected to source terminal. So I will touch this source terminal and I will just touch this drain terminal. So I will get certain value, and that is nothing but VDS. So I will get one reading, first reading, which is 4.68. I will note it down. So my VDS value, first reading practically, is 4.68 volt. Now second thing, I want to measure VGS, and third thing I want to measure ID. So for VGS, I know this terminal is gate terminal, this one, because here we have connected RG. So this is your gate terminal and this is your source terminal. So this red is to be connected to gate terminal and this black is to be connected to source terminal, such a way. You just touch it and we'll get minus reading. Yes, so definitely the VGS value is minus, which is minus 2.038. We'll put it down. So VGS is minus 2.038 volt. And the third one is to find out drain current. So to find drain current, very first thing, you take out this socket from volt and connect it to in milliampere connection. And this rotary switch must be connected, or must be rotated to this milliampere, which is a DC current. Here it is DC and milliampere. So means you are making, or you are finding current. So for current, generally measured in series. So we have to take one slight modification in the circuit. I have to take out this terminal of RD. So what I will do? I will take out this terminal of RD from this side. I will connect somewhere here. And in that particular line I will plug one connecting wire, and I will now connect this red terminal to this wire and this black terminal to the drain terminal of JFET, and I will see the current that I am observing is 2.12 milliampere. That is my ID current. So I will, again I will see, this black terminal is connected to drain terminal of JFET and this red terminal is connected to this connecting wire, and I will measure the current, which is 2.12 milliampere. We call it as drain current. So ID is equal to 2.12 milliampere. So as compared with your theoretical values that we have, this is our practical value. Theoretically, my VDS1 was 4 volt, VGS was minus 2.5 volt, and ID was 2.5 milliampere. So this value came nearby, and hence we have verified DC operating point.